Hello, everybody, and welcome to the AI Cup Lights on the IDFRS Motorsports Network. Our third and final road course on the schedule is at the Portland Road Course. As we look at the point standings, Wynn Charter leads with 411. Steven Charles and Ashit, who did really good at Circuit of the Americas, are now in second and third place. Unfortunately, Landrell is going to have to climb his way back up to get into the top three, and David Seiss has a long road ahead of him. All right, folks, let's get a look at the grid and start today's race. And starting on the pole is Zachary Cool. Next to him is Landrell. Row two is Miles Hart and Ashit. Row three is Calvin Thompson and Homer Sampson. Row four goes to Steven Charles and David Seiss. Row five is Infinity and Lieutenant Dan. Row six is Kyle Bradley and Brad Black. Row 7 is Kelly Banks and Douglas Terry. Row 8 is Bernardo de Oliveira and Forrest Gump. Row 9 is Wynn Charger and Jim Stonoghue. Row 10 is Jeremy Frost and Mitchell Schwarzenruber. Row 11 is Butthead and Gordon Vance. Row 12 is Ethan Oliver and Jacob Schengel. Row 13 is Todd Frazier and Olivier Scott. Row 14 is Victor Lawson and Raja Wolf. Row 15 is Kyle Rigger and Chad Carlson. And in the last row is Gregory Cruz. And with the first lap starting, Zachary Cool pulls ahead of Landrell before going down to turn one. And it's an S of all things. Battle for fourth between Miles Hart, Homer Sampson, and Calvin Thompson. Oh man, Calvin's on the offensive here. Challenging Miles for fourth place. And Ash is just like, please get away from me. And Miles pulls away. At least for now. Down the long straightaway. Well, the bending straightaway, I should say. Let's see if Miles is going to give him any room. Nope, he's going to block him before crisscrossing again on the S's. As we watch everyone cross into lap two, Zachary Cool is our leader, with Landrell in second and Ash in third place. Some heavy braking through the first S. As we watch Lieutenant Dan for just a moment, who's currently in ninth place, if any, being chased down by Kyle Bradley. We got Brad Black, Oliveira, and then Gregory Cruz. As we had a nice panoramic shot of the other cars. Now also testing out some of the camera angles. Yeah, it's pretty much single file for the rest of the pack. Right now focusing on the 29, 39, and 79. All nines. And one of them is starting to fall back. Alright, we see the group spreading out. It was a fun moment while it lasted. Thank you. may be seeing another group forming up of Kyle Bradley, Brad Black, and Oliviera. Down through the sweeping right turn, back onto the front straightaway. Brad chasing down Kyle. A little bit of a slide there from the 43 car, allowing Oliveira to catch up. And it's not going to allow him to keep that gap from shrinking, unfortunately. Cameras continue to roll on our winner from Bristol. As he maintains that 11th place spot. As we look back and keeping our focus on the base car for reasons, we see Donahue challenging Kelly Banks before going down to turn one, almost hitting the barrier, and Kelly is going to slow down, and Donahue is going to use that momentum to slingshot past. Kelly got loose exiting out of that S. Now Kelly's got the deal with Forrest Gump, 44 car, and also Jeremy Frost. Douglas Taylor is now chasing down Todd Frazier on the bendy back straightaway. Donahue looking to use the same maneuver that he did on Kelly Banks against Douglas Terry. Unfortunately, it doesn't work as Terry starts to pull away. Gump chasing down Kelly Banks. And this is going to be for 18th place. Oh, Gump breaks late exiting out of that turn. Frost closing the gap on Gump as they come back onto the front straightaway. Kelly Banks inching further away from Gump. However, Gump is right there in the drafting range of Banks, locking right onto that rear bumper. Gump almost saw an opening, and we just saw Jeremy Frost slide out of the turn. And for Jeremy, that was enough to allow him some breathing room from Butthead in the 69 car. And in the back, we have a side-by-side battle with Jacob Shangle and Gordon Vance. And Shangle's going to hold on to that position from Vance. Let's see if Gordon Vance can pull the same maneuver on Shangle. Now the front straightaway to go, about to complete lap number 9. And they're going to be side by side, heading down towards turn 1. Heavy braking. Vance tries the slingshot maneuver, almost hits Shangle going through the S's. And it's going to be close, exiting out of the S. But Shangle has the advantage. He's going to block Gordon Vance. And behind these two, we see Schwarzenegger and Raja Wolf in the one car. It has not been a good season for the one team. I guess going with OnlyFans was not the smartest move. As we focus on Kelly Banks, we switch our position to Douglas Terry and Todd Frazier. James Donahue is chilling in the back. Three of them come down towards turn 1. Let's see who breaks first. It's going to be Todd Frazier, then Douglas Terry and Donahue. Both the 66 and the 89, or 98, break early, exiting out of the upper hand of the S turn. You trying to reel in Douglas. On the draft of Douglas, but he tries to shake him off down the backstretch. Making their way through the S's, Douglas Terry using what he knows to keep Donahue from catching up. And there's still going to be single file coming towards the start finish line. Six laps left. You see Donahue once again trying the pass on Douglas Terry. Terry goes over the inside rumble strip. Here comes Donahue. They're going to be side by side almost. Donahue gets loose, but tucks back in behind Douglas. Now we have Olivier chasing down Brad Black. And still no change in position as we move back up. You're still in third. And Landrill is trying his best to chase down Zachary. Landrill looking to get his second win in Season 1. And of course it being at a road circuit. Landrill taking it easy on the brakes, following the same pattern as Zachary, and it's going to be even as they exit out of the S's. As we continue looking through the field, Lieutenant Dan putting some distance on Infinity, and Kyle Bradley trying to put some distance on Brad Black and Oliveira. Douglas Terry looking on the inside, trying to pass Todd Frazier, decides to back off. And an opening scene for Jims Donahue. Three drivers doing an accordion. Now Douglas is stuck in the middle, trying to gain but also losing position. Two laps left, and we have not seen a driver come down the pit road yet. So we may be going pit-free this race. And here goes Forrest Gump challenging Kelly Banks before hitting turn one. Both break evenly. Forrest Gump looked like he almost hit the barrier. And Kelly Banks is going to surrender the position to Forrest Gump. Now Gump is away and is about to start moving ahead. now focus on first and second place. Landrill only has 1.5 laps to go now. Zachary is just hitting his points. Landrill try and do the same, but Zachary is just proving too much. White flag, 1 lap to go. If Landrill's looking to do something, now is the time. Less than half a lap to go. Zachary just keeping it cool. Landrill trying to close the gap on him. However, coming down through the last turn, down to the front stretch, checker flag in the air, and the winner is going to go to Zachary Cool. Second, Landrill, and third, Ash. And for the results of today's race, Zachary Coolstar in the pole and won. Landrill gets second, and Ashit gets third. Miles Hart and Callan Thompson round out the top five, along with Homer Sampson, Stephen Charles, David Sace, Lieutenant Dan, Infinity. As we move back to the point standings, Windcharger and Stephen Charles remain where they are comfortably in first and second. Ashit moves back into third place, Infinity drops down one, and Landrill is now in the top five. Kyle Bradley drops a position. Homer Sampson remains where he is. Zachary Cool has now jumped up 7 spots to move into the top 10. And Jim Donahue is now 4 positions behind where he was. A lot of drivers remain where they are, such as Todd Frazier, Jeremy Frost, Ethan Oliver, Gordon Vance, and Butthead. All right, folks, with 2 races left in the season, let's find out next time how drivers will do in the AI Cup Lights.